described and captioned media program in the classroom and online. DCMP.org.
CINEFETE presents Little Garden Animals.
Its teeth cut, and its tongue grates the bits.
Two long tentacles stand up atop its head. Two short tentacles poke out from its face near the mouth.
To find the lettuce, the snail uses its tentacles. The longer upper tentacles are equipped with eyes, and the smaller ones are tactile organs.
The snail's soft, worm-like body slides over a rock.
He's slow, but he's a good climber because his foot produces a slime that enables him to stick to a cabbage leaf.
He hangs off the edge.
Or to any rigid surface.
A snail moves across a sheet of glass. A man's fingers grasp the shell and slowly pluck the snail off the glass. It leaves a long, thin, wet mark. Then in a garden, a man works in a row of red and green lettuces. He sprinkles sawdust around plants.
But sawdust, or cinders,
he pours gray ash around a plant,
will stop them cold.
A snail touches the cinders and shrinks back.
Well done, Mr. Gardener. Your lettuce is safe.
The snail retreats into its shell. Then round white eggs are piled up.
As soon as spring arrives, and then several times again during the summer, all the snails lay their eggs.
Later, tiny clear snails move slowly through the dirt.
3 weeks later, the eggs hatch, and out come the tiny snails. After just 3 months, they'll be full-fledged adults.
A gardener moves boards aside and finds snails.
When the snails disappear, it means good weather. They take shelter and withdraw completely into their shell, which is closed by a flap of tough skin.
The man flips one, showing the flap. Then a hose waters a snail stuck on a pot.
To become active, snails need a little warmth and a lot of humidity.
One snail's shell has blotchy markings, while another's has subtle stripes.
The edible, or burgundy snail, which is larger than the petit gris, is rarely found in gardens.
It moves slowly, its soft body oozing over a rock. It carries a shell that's two shades of brown. More snails have stripes that spiral around the shell.
On the other hand, the banded wood snail is a very frequent visitor. Every snail has its own unique pattern of stripes and colors on its shell.
Snails in different colors slither past, tan, yellow, orange, and striped.
The curious gardener will find a good number of other snails in his garden as well.
A pair with gray-brown shells have black bodies and heads.
This one is no bigger than a shirt button,
with a clear body, almost see-through.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approval list of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.